Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel Making Investments Simple, and today I would be talking about the recent update on the stock markets as on April 11th. And as per the recent correction in stock markets, market is currently awaiting corporate earnings, macro data and top 10 stocks which can give up to 49% returns. So after the rally in the previous four consecutive sessions, the market started consolidation ahead of corporate earnings that will start later in the week, starting April 12th or 13th, and macro data due to tomorrow evening's data. So investors are also closely monitoring crude oil price movement, as Brent crude oil futures on Tuesday crossed the USD $70 a barrel mark and hit the highest level since late 2014. For India, which imports more than 80% of oil requirement, it is a big hit on the fiscal front. Trade war tensions already abated after China announced measures to open up its economy. Now all eyes are on corporate earnings and Karnataka elections, along with crude oil movement. That's what markets are experts are suggesting. So January was a great month for the market, but the D Street saw a correction of more than 10% from all-time high levels seen earlier after the Union Budget 2018. So we are seeing a pullback rally and beaten down stocks that have performed well from the up move we are seeing from March 23. So we could see another 100 to 200 points spike as the earnings season is about to start. So major part of the focus will be on earnings season, the street will be watching out for the commentary as well, which is currently worrisome. So Chola Securities, which also said investors would keenly await signs of pickup in the corporate earnings in the upcoming financial year 2018 earnings season, expects in the medium term the markets to be watchful of the outcome of the investigations in the banking space post PNB scam. So here is the list of top 10 stocks which can give up to 49% return. So now the first one would be Exide Industries. Now Exide Industries net sales grew 32.7% year on year to 22,280 crores, driven by growth in automotive, UPS, telecom and infrastructure batteries, and margin contracted to 12.4%. PAT grew 1.8% year on year to 154 crore. And Exide is looking strong, and there is a huge support at 200-205 levels, and there is a buy rating from brokerage house Motilal Oswal, and the buy target is priced at 268 rupees, so that is approximately 12% return. Now the stock would be Jubilant Life Sciences. The buy rating is buy target of 957, a return of 17% is expected. And Jubilant Life Science, JLS, is engaged in the manufacturing of radio pharmaceuticals, allergy products, advanced intermediates, nutritional products and life science chemicals. So we expect specialty pharma to grow at a 16% CAGR, adjusting for the Triad business over financial year 17-20. So and Pidilite Industries is the third stock from this rating, is buy target of 1065 and expected to give you a 9% return. So it's Pidilite Industries is the largest branded adhesives player in India. Apart from the strong presence in adhesives, company has expanded into emerging segments like mechanized joinery, modular furniture, flooring, automotive care and waterproofing through Dr. Fixit and Roof. So PD offers a high quality discretionary play with a strong competitive positioning, proven in market excellence and an impeccable track record of generating long term shareholder value over multiple periods. So a revival of volume growth and a strong potential shift from unorganized players over the next 2-3 years outweigh near term margin worries. We have a buy rating on the stock with a target price of 1065. Power Grid Corporation is another buy signal with a return of 46% and a target of 287. So Power Grid Corporation has around 1 lakh crores of orders pending execution, providing strong visibility of EPS CAGR of around 12% over financial year 18 to 22. The earnings estimate factors in a 150 BP cut in regulated return on equity ROE, return of earnings to 14% in the next tariff regulations. However, with the bond yield rising over the last few months, the extent of such cut could be lower in our view. Mahindra and Mahindra is the market leader in UV and tractors with market share of over 40% in both segments. And we are expecting a return of 15% from the current trading buy price, from which is trading around 700 and 800, and it is expected to give 15% return based on its company's strong momentum. Raymond is another stock which can give up to 49% returns with a target of 1535. And Raymond has undertaken a series of strategic initiatives to chart out a course of sustained growth and improve profitability, steered by a recently inducted professional management at the helm. We expect revenues to grow at a CAGR of 11.7% to 7,463.3 crore by financial year 20. So the icing of the cake is a veritable premium land bank of approximately 125 acres in the heart of Thane city, the fastest growing real estate in the outskirts of Mumbai. Natco Pharma, with a buy rating of and target of a 908, with a return expected of 16%. It's a R&D focused, vertically integrated pharmaceutical company with an experienced management team and presence across multiple specialty therapeutic segments. It has high emphasis on R&D and complex molecules, focusing on long-term stability and growth. It recently raised rupees 915 crores to fund capacity additions. Another strong stock would be Finolex Cables, with a buy rating and target of 800, with a return expected of 14% in the next 2-3 years. So Finolex Cables posted lower revenue growth versus peers in past 2-3 years, largely owing to weak housing demand, where the company has major around 60% of revenues presence compared to peer set 2. Management seemed upbeat on communication cables segment, and we estimate the unit to log around 25% CAGR over the next 2-3 years. Another strong stock would be Heidelberg Cement, with a buy rating and target price of 205 rupees, and a return expected of 32%. And there are number of expectations for healthy Q4 numbers, mainly to be aided by healthy volume in central markets. Another strong stock would be NCC, which has recently given a breakout above 131. In NCC, there are expectation of healthy performance in coming quarters, owing to robust construction activities and healthy order book. NCC added orders worth 21,600 crore in financial year 2018 versus 2009 I'm sorry 9,300 crores in financial year 2017, led by significant order addition from roads and highways and building segments. Current order book at 31,600 crore offers promising growth visibility in the coming year. So we expect NCC to grow at 14% returns and a target price of 150 rupees the coming few years. So these are the top 10 fundamental buy recommendations, which can give up to 49% return. And we, as market is awaiting corporate earnings, we expect these numbers can go up in the coming few months. So hope you enjoyed this information video. If you have any comments on my videos, please feel free to write to me, and I'll be happy to answer them. I'll be happy to take your feedback. Thank you, and I will see you again on my next video.